Fargo with his pals Spinner and Paddlefoot and a missing train. You remember last time, Clutch and Company flew to Robber's Flats after receiving a telephone call from Sheriff Shotgun Lafferty. A complete train with a $50,000 gold shipment was missing. When they arrived, no one was there. Inside the railroad office...
Golly, I hope he's all right.
He got a nasty crack on the head. Otherwise, he seems to be okay. Come on, Shotgun. Wake up. You're okay. Wake up.
You varmints, take them masks off. You're fooling with the law.
Whoa, whoa, Shotgun. We're friends. I'm Clutch Cargo.
Fool with me, will you, Clutch Cargo?
What happened?
What happened? Look at this room. Two masked men sneaked in while I was receiving a message. They both had guns, and I don't mean play guns. When I wouldn't tell them what the message said, they slugged me. That's all I remember.
Do you think it had anything to do with the missing train?
Well, no, it wouldn't surprise me at all. Sure hate to think that after all these years, the robbers are coming back to Robber's Flats.
Gosh, just like the days of the Old West.
Who was on that train when it disappeared?
Just two people, the engineer and the fireman. No passengers allowed. Restricted gold shipment.
Where have you looked for the missing train?
All along the 40-mile track, clean to Polecat Bend. Never found hide nor hair of her.
Is there a hand car we can use?
Sure is.
Are we going to drive it, Clutch?
That's right, Spinner.
Whoopee! Whoop! Whoop!
Take it real slow over the big trestles, or you'll flip her and end up in the river 200 feet below. I wish I could go with you, but somebody's got to keep law and order in Robert Flat.
We'll be back soon, I hope.
So long, Mr. Sheriff Shotgun.
Clutch and Company speed along the track, looking for a possible hiding place for the missing train.
I think I can get a good view of the track from here, Spinner. You and Paddlefoot stay on the car while I take a look.
Clutch sees that the track goes down the side of the mountain in the big S curve, first turning back on itself, then going on again to the dangerous trestle bridge. At that moment, Paddlefoot, by accident, knocks against the handcar's speed control and off it goes.
Spinner, turn off the motor.
His only chance to save them before they reach the dangerous trestle is to cut directly down the mountain. Faster and faster speeds the car. It whips around the first bend. Clutch knows that his last chance to stop the speeding hand car is to reach it after it goes around the final bend.
Gotta stop it before the trestle.
The hand car whips into the second bend.
Hang on, Paddlefoot. Here we go!
Made it. You and Paddlefoot okay?
Who, you? Yeah. Sure was a fast ride.
Clutch and Company continue on in the hand car. Then, rounding a bend...
Clutch! Look!
Company escape a crash? Be sure to tune in for the next exciting episode with Clutch Cargo.